Yeah, I'm ready. Selamat siang, all. Yeah, many people. I'm so excited. So today, I am talk about in this title, how can we contribute to Ubuntu Day from especially Asia. So this is my self introduction. I am Mino Takeyama from Japan, and my Ubuntu Day ID is Mtake, and I am a community member, community developer of Ubuntu Day, which means I work for Ubuntu Day on the weekends and midnight of weekdays. And I'm doing a maintenance of OpenSUSE M17N. M17N is a multilingual station. And I'm also organizer of OpenSUSE user group in Japan. And I talk about activities of OpenSUSE user group later. And then I am OpenSUSE Asia Summit committee from 2014. So I'm so very happy I can see this many people joining Ubuntu Day Japan. Thank you for coming. So let me define this important word, contribution. In this talk, contribution to open source software means that someone for you take effort to make some value for open source software and its community. Writing code or fixing some bugs are, of course, a respectable contribution. And also helping someone else who are in trouble with some problem, it is also good contribution. So I have a question here. So do you have any experience to do some contribution to some open source project? Anything okay? Anything other than open source is okay? Anyone? Oh yes. And then next question is, do you want to start a contribution to some open source software? Yeah, good. So this talk is for you. Right? So contribution to open source means that sometimes it's contribution to variety of software, open source software on Ubuntu. So you know, OpenSUSE is not just a single open source product. We have, for example, Linux kernel. Linux kernel is an open source product. We cannot miss it, right? And LibreOffice is a presentation software. And I cannot do my presentation without LibreOffice. And we have GNOME and Firefox, which provides us a great desktop environment. So during contribution to OpenSUSE, we sometimes involved with those many open source products. We call those open source products upstream. Yes, so let's go. And before you are starting your contribution, one thing I have to say is joining some communities which is related to what you want to do is very important. So, for example, if you are interested in development, in, for example, packaging or for releasing something, you have to subscribe mailing list of open source factory mailing list, which is very important for open source developers. And if you are interested in packaging, there's another mailing list. And Please join fast. Don't make it fast. This is because for your contribution, so find you people who will help you or who will work with you is very important. So you can touch such people in those communities. So today, the topic is this is here. I have only limited time, so I will talk about these four kinds of contribution. So some of them is not a not require technical skill. So maybe you can start some kind of these contribution. The first one is bug reporting. Here's the question: when did you do when you encountered a bug? For example, when application crashes. If you want the bug to be fixed, the good contribution to open source is reporting the bug you found to developers of that application. Where should we report to? So please inform, please report, send report to bug tracking system. OpenSUSE uses a bug seeder for bug tracking system, which is available from at bug seeder OpenSUSE.org. Bug seeder is a web-based application which manages bugs from reporting to resolve. And we need more reporters from Asia because some bugs happen only in Asian environment, and some applications are used only in Asian countries. For example, in Asian countries. So to improve the quality of those applications, we need your help. So what is bug seeder like? So this is a screenshot of bug seeder. First, you select the component you found the bug, and then select the version of OpenSUSE, and then write a summary of your bug in one line, and finally write this description. It's easy. It's all. No, it's not all. So just reporting is not enough. Because we can easily find many bug reports that is abandoned. Don't no one take care for several years. So what do we need to do so that the bug is really fixed? To really resolve bug, you need to write enough information to that bug report. So first one is enough information so that developers can reproduce the bug. So maybe you need to step to reproduce and actual result. And the second information is enough information to understand what is happening. For example, screenshots and problematic files is very useful. And bug traces generated by GDB is also useful information. And so make developers feel that, wow, this bug should be resolved as soon as possible is very important. So here's the worst case caused by your bug. If the bug have a security risk or code를 되도록 please don't forget to write that part. And this one is in the easy thing. You need to keep to be contacted. Sometimes developers need your help if they cannot reproduce your bug. This kind of this situation sometimes happens while I'm so fixing some CJK, Chinese and Japanese, Korean bugs. Because to reproduce that bug, the developers sometimes need a special environment like keyboard for Chinese environment. But I can't prepare for that. In such case, you have to help and work with developers. And confirming your bug is confirming your bug is really resolved or not is also your task. So please don't go away before your bug is resolved. And informing your bug to appropriate developers is also important. Not all developers cannot resolve your bug. Only limited developers can do that. So find such developers in, for example, changelogs, and add them to CC list of Bugzilla. So Bugzilla have a CC list screenshot view. If you add them, the mail is handed to this CC. And share your report in public mailing list is a good idea. Maybe good developers are subscribing such list, so your report can be informed by them. So the next topic is packaging. What is packaging? Packaging is creating RPM package so that every OpenSUSE user can easily install applications and libraries by using Zipper or YAML. We need more people from especially Asia who can help make a package because we sometimes need to maintain applications that is used on the Asian countries or some region specific applications. For example, font is sometimes region specific. And input method is a kind of application to input complex characters such as Japanese and maybe Japanese is also complex characters, have a complex character. In packaging, there's many things you can do. So there's many easy tasks if you know how to build a package, build an application from source code, you can do that. You can do packaging. So thanks to open build service, you can everyone can join packaging of OpenSUSE. This is an overview of packaging process in OpenSUSE. You copy, suppose that you want to update Firefox, right? What you have to do is four things. First, you copy the original one from OpenSUSE project, and then you update the Firefox, and then submit it back to original OpenSUSE project. do that on so this task or open media service. So how to update packages by using OBS? For now, I quickly show you how to use OSC command, which is a command line interface of OpenView service. First, you just type a branch command, and this copies some packages from OpenSUSE project to your home working directory, which is located online. Then, OSC takeout, download the copied package into your local machine, and then now you can start to update the copied package. So here, I type wget command and download a new source code to the local machine. And then, modify spec file. Spec file is a file containing the how to build the package. And you have to change the version number. And the building package is very easy. Just type OSC build command. OSC build command require virtual environment to build a package. So you don't need to install many packages for development, for example, main or GCC. And you can get the admin package you build from your virtual environment. And this is your package. And if you think it's okay, you write a change log. And you can submit by OSCSR command. It's all. So maybe you think you can do that. There is also web-based user interface. It is very useful. So you can see this. When you write from buildobsidian.org, so please check it. Third topic is a translation. This type of contribution don't require technical coding skills. So if you are not good at coding, you can start translation. Most of the open source applications provide English user interface. But we are Asian, right? So we sometimes, want the translated user interface for Asian language. So to make applications Asian friendly, we need more people who do translation for open source products. Translation of OpenSUSE to translate OpenSUSE, we have two approaches. First one is translating OpenSUSE specific tools like Jinpa Oya. And another approach is translating applications of on OpenSUSE. Like, for example, translating Firefox or LibreOffice. Also, the latter one is also important because we take much time with these applications. So, how can we do translation of applications? And how difficult? It's easy. If you know how, why on application menu should be translated in your language. Maybe you know that. I can read Barkas? Barkas?
Yes.
If you know that, you can start translation. It's enough, right? How can do that? We can use a very useful tool like localize. So localize is an application like this, and you select the text you want to translate from the left, and the original text is shown above, and you write the translated text into the next text box. That's all. And there's a web-based translation tool. Web-based translation tool allows you to translate without any version control system or something like that. OpenSUSE specific tools use WebRay. This is also web-based. And about documents, we have many documents to be translated. And many documents are not translated in Indonesian. So please, if you have interest, please find your teammate and let's translate. And I have also not many times. So finally, I talk about the fourth topic, marketing. Marketing is a very simple thing. Spread OpenSUSE around you. So I am doing marketing activities as a member of OpenSUSE user group, Japan OpenSUSE user group. We have a booth in many open source events held in Japan. And this is the booth at the open source conference, and this is a picture of seminar. And having OpenSUSE events is also a good idea. So next month we have a release of 42.2. So let's have a release party in our local city. And publishing magazine for our service is also a good idea. Do you know Comic Market? Selling these magazines at the Comic Market. Comic Market is the biggest festival for selling self-publishing mangas or something like that. And if you are interested in marketing, please subscribe to OpenSUSE marketing list. And before you join some open source events, please update event list that is available on our OpenSUSE wiki. So now it's time to close. As I explained, there are many tasks you can do. And we need more contributors from Asia because many applications there's many applications for Asia. And to make applications for Asian friendly. And this is the important thing. Let's have a lot of fun during your contribution. Thank you.
Oke, okay, terima kasih ke Bapak Profesor Takayama. Ya. Yeah. Susi.
And if you there's people who can read some Japanese, I have 3 copies of Giko magazine here. So, you can get it. No one, there is anyone who can read Japanese one.
Yang di Jepang, Jepang City itu sama.
こんばんは。
こんばんは。
え？
Can you read?
Ano Indonesia no koto ga Indonesia no dou desu ka?
Indonesia no nan
desu ka? Say
English. Three, two, one.
Go!
Yomi
Baik.